This is Dolmades 101 with Greek Cindy YaYa.
One and a third pounds of ground lamb.
That's what we start with.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm adding a patty of grass-fed ground beef. Just gives it a little different flavor. Okay. The lamb and the beef have a really good flavor together. Now I'm chopping up at least a half of a big onion. This is going to be diced up and put into the meat mixture.
Step.
Okay, next I have fresh parsley, and I'm just going to snip it. I have a whole bunch. I'm just going to snip it with the scissors into the meat mixture because it will cook down. So I'm just snipping it into here.
Cool.
Even the stems, a little bit of the stems, it doesn't matter. It'll cook down. Oops.
Smell it. It smells so good. Wish you had
some. Okay, and this is from Penzi's Spices. You can see it. It says Greek seasoning. Yeah. I'm going to put probably like a half a teaspoon of Penzi's in here just because I like it. You don't have to, but I really like the taste of it. So, and then I'll put in just a little olive oil because it will kind of hold it together a little bit. So probably maybe a tablespoon of olive oil.
Okay. Action.
I'm going to use organic long grain basmati white rice, but you can use brown rice as well. And this is probably about a half a cup. So I'm just going to add that to the meat mixture. Okay, so now I'm going to mix it. So I have lamb, just over a pound of lamb, one ground beef patty, half of a large onion, a large bunch of fresh parsley, and about a half a cup of basmati rice, and about half a teaspoon to a teaspoon of Greek seasoning, or you can just put in a half a teaspoon of salt. And I put in about a tablespoon of olive oil just to hold it together.
Okay.
Okay, so you just mix it together really good. Some people use their hands. That's fine, but I'm using a spoon. And there you have it. Your Dolmades mixture. And this will be rolled in your grape leaves. Okay. This is a very important part of making Dolmades. We're picking grape leaves. And these do not bear fruit like a normal grapevine. And I'll show you the leaf. The leaf is pretty distinctive. It has very jagged edge to it all the way around. You want to pick it at least this big so you can roll it. Actually, the bigger it is, the easier it is to roll. So you want to make sure it's about this size or smaller, a little smaller. And then you're going to put about a tablespoon of mixture in here to roll it up. I'm going to blanch these when I get back. I'll put them in boiling water for about a minute, and they'll soften up, and then they'll be easier to roll. Okay, now this is a very important part. This is where we're going to blanch the grape leaves for just like a minute, okay? I have boiling water here with just a little bit of salt in it, sea salt. And then I'm just going to drop in, hold on one second. Okay, I'm just going to drop in the grape leaves. And you will see them change color quickly. And I'll show you what I mean with my spoon. If I put them under the water, and you'll smell a very distinct smell. Okay, do you see how they were really bright green? Mm-hmm. And now they're kind of an army green?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so they've changed colors. So I let them boil for just maybe 30 seconds more. And then I'll do the rest of them. And then I'm going to drain them over here in the colander. Okay, let them drain well. And then we'll start to roll them. leaves. If you use a slotted spoon, it helps because you get some of the water out. Putting them all in the colander.
Sorry, I'm really impressed.
So we're ready to roll our tamales. Here we go. I'm going to use a paper plate just because it's going to keep things a little cleaner. I'm going to use my hands. Make sure you wash your hands, or you can put gloves on. But okay, we're on the last couple of steps. Our tamales have been rolled, and they're in the pot, and they're in layers. There's two or three layers of tamales in here, and then I had a little extra meat mixture, so don't throw it away. I just made it into some patties, and I'll grill those later, or you can fry them or broil them, but you can always use the mixture, okay? And then I take just diced tomatoes, and I'm going to pour them over the tamales, and I'll take my spoon. I'm just going to spread this over them. These will boil down, and then a very important step is you want to take a plate that fits inside your pot, and this is going to fit in just like that. Why do you put a plate in the pot? So they don't unroll while they're cooking and all the mixture comes out. You want the mixture to stay in the tomatoes leaf. You want them to stay tightly rolled while they're cooking. So I'll put a little water in there before they cook. So essentially we're done, except for they'll cook for at least an hour.